about 30 miles from here.
30 miles is where it started, the Puritans and I guess Lester Friend and so on.
Yep.
Joe Hild.
Hild was from New Jersey.
Okay, but he went up there.
Harry Hansen from Winters, New Jersey.
Yeah.
Ed Gilson, who was a member of the New Jersey
club. Yeah. I remember Ed Gilson.
Yeah.
And a lot of the engines, I don't know, there's lots and lots of engines. Who knows where they're at?
They're hidden away in cellars somewhere.
Yeah. It's been a resurge of this scale, the economy being what it is, and expensive. Pulling a big 1,500-pound locomotive like a 1361 around, we find it much nicer. You can enjoy a meet without having to move this 1,500-pound engine, and you can have a lot of fun. And yesterday, as you well know, was my first attempt at riding the elevated, and now I'm going to get a shot on a steam locomotive, and Danny's out there right now running, but we'll see. So now this club here started where?
In Ashland, Massachusetts.
Okay, and was it
not far from here?
Is that the guy that was the captain or something?
Captain Childs. That was the second property. The first was in Ashland, and the president of the club was a fellow by the name of Charlie Shabbat. And the engine that you're going to be running in a few minutes was built by Charlie Shabbat in the late 1930s.
Okay,
and then they moved to Framingham, and now they're in Holliston.
Right. So the club, and that's where we're here this weekend, is the 55th anniversary. Why do they say 40th, 55th? Why is that? I don't understand that.
But, not sure.
You mean either. But it's 55 years of the club since it began. And 90% of that time was, I guess 80% of the time was 3/4 and 1-inch elevated. And then when they came here.
Inch and a half.
They came with the inch and a half. But Lester Friend was in the Joytown original Hudson is here. Which kind of goes way back before, in the 50s, right?
Yep.
Before little engines got into it.
Yep.
Before little engines got into inch and a half,
oh,
right?
Oh, yeah.
Now, 7 1/4, the world gauge, all over the world standard. All right, Keith. Nice seeing you again.
Good seeing you too, Dave. Always a pleasure.
Fire the engine, you gotta make sure water's in there, and you gotta keep your balance. You gotta think of all these things.
Okay,
it's pretty cool.
Today's Sunday. Yesterday we had so many people here, I had to park out on the road quite a ways from here, and I was thinking of taking the MTA in here, Metropolitan Transit Authority. But turned out to be a pretty good weekend. The weather was beautiful. People here at Washakum Club are awesome. They're a bunch of nice fellows, very hospitable. Got to meet some people I knew off the Chaski that are having new old friends, as Jack says. And we're about ready to head back down south to the Garden State. So I guess we'll see you again on the next video. Thanks for watching.
Well, let me tell you of the story of a man named Charlie on a tragic and fateful day. He put 10 cents in his pocket, kissed his wife and family, went to ride on the MTA. Well, did he ever return? No, he never returned there.
and his fate is still unlearned.
What a pity.
He may ride forever neath the streets of Boston. He's the man who never returned. Charlie handed in his dime at the Kendall Square station, and he changed for Jamaica Plain. When he got there, the conductor told him one more nickel. Charlie couldn't get off of that train. But did he ever return? No, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever neath the streets of Boston. He's the man who never returned. Now all night long, Charlie rides through the station crying, what will become of me? How can I afford to see my sister in Chelsea or my cousin in Roxbury? But did he ever return? No, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever neath the streets of Boston. He's a man who never returned. Charlie's wife goes down to the Scully Square station every day at 2:15. And through the open window she hands Charlie a sandwich as the train comes rumbling through. But did he ever return? No, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever neath the streets of Boston. He's the man